In this tutorial, we're going to create a custom ammo and weapon pickup point for our custom weapon. That's if you've already got a custom weapon in the UDK, but even if you haven't, you can use this ammo, this weapon pickup point for existing weapons. I'll show you that in a moment. So what I've done is I've been in Max and I've created a box, an ammo box basically, and it's open. And we could put some ammo in there just to make it look like, although no, there are people silly doing that because this is for all weapons, and so unless you were prepared to put all static meshes of all the weapons, ammo for all the weapons in there to make it look like it's an ammo box full of all the ammo for weapon types. But what I've already done as well in the UDK, I've made a particle system so it glows green, I think. Yeah, green inside, or red it might be. So that when you've picked a weapon up, the glow goes out, and then when you walk away, and it respawns a weapon. So I've changed all the sounds for picking up a weapon as well, because I'm not going to be using many of the UDK weapons, and so I've got an M16 and an AK-47, and then now the sound when you pick a weapon up is a cocking gun sound. But I'll show you that shortly. So that's approximately the size you want it on the grid, if you can see that. Whatever you're going to create. I couldn't tell you what the dimensions are. But a simple thing to do if you're unsure of units in the UDK, because they're completely crazy, the unit system, compared to any other modelling or game engine, modelling program or game engine. I think it's because Americans still use their version of inches, which is the only version in the world that uses that, whereas 99.9% of the rest of the world uses metric now. So even we've abandoned our imperial unit system because it was rubbish, basically. So this is why it's difficult to translate over, but you can reset your units by going customize and all that rubbish, but I can't be bothered every time I'm doing something. So what I end up doing is I have a reference weapon mesh, and I think if you've watched other tutorials of mine you will see that. And so go import merge down in weapons. It might not be in this file, it might be in UDK weapons actually. Let's just have a look first. It's just called reference weapon box, or box reference. So now it's back, and then go into UDK files, weapons, UDK reference, weapon reference box, and there you go. That is basically the size of my M16 and my AK-47 in the editor. They are slightly too small, they need to be adjusted to sizes, but I always use this reference box when I'm importing something into UDK. So as you can see, if that was the M16 was above it now, rotating, which is what it does at a weapon locker, it wouldn't look too silly, that box. So what we'll do is we'll delete out the reference box, and I'm quite happy with that size there. And the next thing to do is to unwrap UVW. I've already done that, because I didn't want to waste time doing stuff like that in tutorial. So I've unwrapped it and I've textured it, so it's got a number on the front. You can hardly read the number, but it's not important. And then a number on the back. I could write ammo on the top, I suppose. You know, because it's an ammunition box as such. But I'm not going to bother, because this is perfectly alright. You know, I mean, the reason I've put those numbers on the front there is because they have those sort of stenciled numbers in to say what type of artillery or bullets are in them. ammunition boxes do. And so for what I'm doing, it's ideal. So you can see it without its UV map on to get a clearer look at it. It looks pretty much like the real McCoy. And obviously inside at the moment there are no textures applied because you could double side the texture in 3DS Max, but it's too much hassle. Because I've already got a double-sided material in UDK that I've created from the UV texture of this, which I'll quickly show you now. I'm going to shut down classes at the moment. Now to get this running, there's a lot of work to do. Don't get me wrong, it's not simple. Well no, actually the weapon pickup point is easy, but your ammo point and weapon, all the special effects for your weapon, there's a lot of classes involved in changing all that, and it's not simple. But we'll run through all that over the next couple of tutorials. So let's show you the texture quick for this. Documents M6, oh, where's that gone? It's pictures, isn't it? M16 ammo box. It's one of these, so no, not, it's not the magazine. And that little cutout here is from a real ammo box, so let's open them. And these are the cartridges for the weapon, for the ammo pickup as well. I use those to create my bullets. Now I've got the bullets a bit large in the editor as well, because I thought, well, you wouldn't have them really small. But maybe they could do with being a little bit smaller. I'll show you them in a moment. So first of all, let's just quickly show you, that's the cut, oh there's the bullets, that's the texture there for the ammo box, really simple, from the UVW, and I just did these two cutouts from that little piece there, which is the centre of a real ammo box, placed those in the two centres of the box, and then copied the texture, the two different colours, so I painted one on first using the pencil tool, then the second one I just done loads of scribbling on it, and then I smudged it and blurred it with the smudge and blur tool to give it that sort of old grey dirty effect, and now it works fine. It could do with some more work and that, but for what I'm doing for tutorials and that, I'm not that bothered about it. So that's that text, and then the ammo text. This is the ammunition texture for the custom weapon pickup. Custom ammo pickup, I should say. Now this involved a lot of class alterations as well, or custom classes, and I'll quickly show you those. So now my class folder is growing massively, just because I extended my custom weapon from the UT shock rifle. There are a lot of little bits involved with that, lots of different classes that are attached to it, so I've had to create my custom versions of all of them, and at least all the ones that say M16, I'll just quickly show you, and then the custom weapon pickup point, so is what we're creating at the moment. It's ridiculous really why they've created so many classes just for one weapon. I've got that twice. No, I haven't, no. Custom damage type. Ah yeah, that damage, custom damage type is where I've doubled it up, so that's wrong. Sorry, undo the M16, there we go. Those are all the classes for one weapon. Now ignore this one, custom damage type, so let's undo that. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 classes for a single weapon. It's crazy, isn't it? So, but these will all be available on the website, so you don't have to go through all this ordeal of altering them. But I'll quickly show you what they look like inside now. They're referencing all my assets, and where I haven't got an asset for them, i.e. like some of the particle effects. So the muzzle flash light class now is mine here. The pickup sound cue is mine. It's still also referencing the shock rifle pickup sound cue, so I've got to delete that out. It's somewhere else referenced in the code, but I haven't found it yet. This class here, I've not managed to find that in the class's files yet, so I haven't altered it yet, but I haven't commented it out either. But to comment it out, all you do is just add two forward slashes behind it, just like this. And see, it goes green now. It wouldn't be red by the engine, but I'm not doing that at the moment. Undo until I find the class. It might not be in the UT game class, it might be somewhere else. So now the instant hit damage type is M16 damage type. Again, that's the same one, the UT projectile shot ball. Weapon 1 mesh is my mesh, it's my attachment class here. Again, my mesh here for the first and third person meshes. The anim set is commented out at the moment because I had a problem with it, so I've just commented it out so that it's not read by the engine at the moment. And so that's it, that's just the weapon itself, the weapon class. Close that. Yes, I do want to save. And then the next one is the pickup factory that we're working on now. Let's shut this AK-47 class. So custom weapon pickup factory, and I'll also open the custom weapon pickup light. This one of these references a particle effect here. The custom weapon pickup the weapon pickup factory, UT weapon pickup factory, the normal one, references a particle effect here. So that's where you need to create your particles and place them in there. Then the static mesh, basically the weapon pickup box in the editor, I'll show you that quickly. Now there is the normal one with that glow light on it and that. So that we want to get rid of, and we want to convert it to that. Oh, there's my ammunition as well, but we'll go into that in a moment. I've got to re-import the ammo box because I don't know if you can see what that the floor is showing through there. What that is where it was on the grid in Max. When I first imported it, it was below the grid here. And when you place it in your map, so say you went add such and such weapon pickup point here now in the map and build the paths, the path builder pushes it down to where it should be, and if you try to move it upwards or sideways, then you have to rebuild the paths and it just places it back to where it should be. So you need to make sure when you create your mesh in Max that it's exactly on the grid, or it can be slightly above it but not through it, and centered by using transform tool and then right clicking on these two little things here so it's centered to the world, and then laying level on the grid. So the next thing is back in the classes folder. So yeah, that will be referencing then our ammo box, our static mesh basically, and it doesn't need to be an interpactor, just a weapon, static mesh. And then the next thing is the weapon pickup sound, that is mine now, and that's all we're referencing now in the custom weapon pickup. So the weapon pickup isn't that difficult to change. The hardest part you're going to have is creating the particle system for it. Or you could just comment that out and have no particles on it and just have a box. Or anything. It doesn't have to be a box. It could be a dead man laying on the floor with a gun floating above him. A mesh. It could be just use your imagination, really. But I thought of an ammo box with a gun rotating above it. So, let's quickly show you it in action. Before we do, I want to re-import it. So I'm going to re-export this. Export. And I want ammo box opened. Wherever it is. Ammo box open, that one there. Go save. Yeah, replace the old one. I'm doing it as FBX, user defined as well. So I've got no animation checked. I've got geometry, just smoothing groups and turbo smooth. Animation, nothing checked there. Cameras, no cameras because there's no cameras with it. Lights, no lights. Embedded media, I've got that checked, which is basically, I'm sure it helps with the materials. And then advanced options, units set on auto. Axis conversion, Z up, or Z up if you're English. UI, show warning manager, so if there's any errors with it, I get a warning as it goes out. Now, this is where I've changed the format. I'm not using the 2011 FBX file format. The reason being, I sent someone some models on the internet the other night, and I used the FBX 2011, and they only had Max 2010, and the FBX wouldn't work with them. So I've got it down to 2010 at the moment, so all my exports have can be used in Max 2010 if someone needs these models, you know. If, say, for example, you're watching this now and you want this model, just email me on my website, which is, there's a link to it on my channel, and I will send you the models rather than creating them yourselves, and then you can sort of spice them up and add some different effects to them if you want. So that's the FBX file format I'm using. So I'm going to go OK now. That's our box exported, and then we go back into UDK. Content browser, find the weapon pickup, custom weapon pickup factory. Here we are, here's my particle effect, and my textures and materials. So I'm going to go re-import static mesh. Now we'll quickly, I don't know if anything happened there, we'll soon see. Yep, it did. See, notice it's out of the floor now, but when I go into the, I'm going to move them ammo a bit down a bit, they're a bit close to the box. When I go into the editor now, I'll probably say path need building, so I'm going to do that anyway. Close, and then make sure my ammo box is still out of the floor. Yep, perfect. So the next thing is, when you want to add your new custom ammo box and you've added the class to it in your SRC, your file structure, well, say for example you've downloaded my class from my website, which you can do because it'll be up there tonight. So it'll be called Custom Weapon Pickup Factory, but you can change that. You can call it, you know, John or Jane Smith's Weapon Pickup Factory. There is no, as long as you change the class name on the actual name of the folder of the file, and then inside the class itself. I'll show you that in a moment, what I mean. Yeah, I can't show you. Just, oh yeah, I have got context open, right. So this is the file name inside the file. So Custom Weapon Pickup Factory, that could be Jane Smith Weapon Pickup Factory, but outside of the folder as well, that also needs to be the identical name there as well. That